situation first, which sectors are going to be benefited, which are the least benefited. Then we will talk about the equity markets. Then we'll talk about where the money is lying, how the world made money, how the hedge funds in US, how these alternate investment funds in India, and how these big investors are making money. So we'll talk about a little bit on that also. Anyways, we are basically commodity equity currency brokers from Rajasthan, having network across India. And me and Nishant, we will be presenting today's session. And in fact, we are very happy that, you know, we have been regular attendees, me and Nishant, in fact, must be having the records. Main to hamesha bolta hum log rudali hai, time hai, koi bhi seminar ho, kaisa bhi ho, hum log har seminar mein aate hain. And after attending so many webinars, Kailash ji and Dheeraj ji, main, Nishant, hum log regular aate hain. And this time, it's an opportunity to present in front of the Thai members. So, maza to aane wala hai. So, I'm very excited also at the same time. So it's corona all over. Gaane bhi ban gaye iske upar, and then you know corona outbreak 31 December ko hua tha 2019 mein, but till you know 15th February to say 29th February, people were not realizing in India how the things can be. And believe me, on 31st of January I was in Mumbai airport, because first I had a special budget show on Zee Business, and I saw some, you know, employees of GMR Infra, because they are GBK and GMR, they are managing the Delhi and Mumbai airports. And that time they were using masks, and it was so funny for me to see them in masks. Then I got a selfie with them. So, but I never knew that, you know, after 2 months, everyone will be wearing masks everywhere. So 31st December, and now it's already more than 105 days, I think 105th day today. So things have changed. So now this is the biggest threat after global economy, to the global economy since the financial crisis of 2007 and 2008. So let's see 2007-08 ki global crisis ke baad, and that time, you know, India was not affected. It was the US and the European countries, they were the worst affected, and India ke markets toote the, and then, you know, it took around 2 years to recover. And then 2012-13 things started getting better. Then 2014 the new government came in, and then things started getting better. But still, that time the economy was in a very good phase, the Indian economy, and it was doing very well from 2003-04 to 2007-08. So we could withstand that particular pressure, you know. But now things are not that rosy, or the economy was not doing well. So let's see how we are going to, you know, work out after this corona thing and lockdown. So we will talk about the topic. The quick spread of the corona, the latest pandemic, is wreaking havoc on the world economies and in the financial markets, causing capital flight, currency devaluation, threatening a global economic recession. And with reference to this context, we will discuss how we will first survive, then thrive, and finally making money. So sabse pehle to challenge hai ki survive kaise karna, because sab kuch haywire ho gaya hai, things are totally in doldrums. Businesses काफी losses में आएंगे, बहुत सारे infrastructure cost होते हैं, salary cost होती है. So SMEs, MSMEs will have very tough time. We are in the lockdown too. So May 3rd तक देखते क्या होता है. उसके बाद भी I don't think so things will get easily recovered. So first we will talk about survival, then we will talk about thriving, and then finally, you know, making money. So 40 days of lockdown, working from home, no outside activities. We all are at home. In fact, I think Trump bhi ghar pe hai, to Johnson bhi ghar pe hai, India mein Modi ji bhi ghar pe hai, to apna peon bhi ghar pe, hum sab ghar pe hai at the same time. And literally, you know, webinars all across the year. Abhi sabse zyada agar kuch ho raha hai to Zoom ho raha hai aur webinars ho rahe hain. And I think Thai has become so aggressive, itne sare events, event after event ki, in fact baat hi nahi kar pati ki kitne sare events ho rahe hain. So I think mera jo slot hai 15th April ka, it got finalized on I think 7th or 8th. Uske beech mein bhi 6 webinar ho chuke hain, and all webinars are actually very very useful, very fruitful, and sab value addition hua sabka. So I think, you know, this thing will continue also. So it will be webinar even after the lockdown is over, and we have got a new perspective now. telecommuting has become the norm for most of the companies. Alcohol companies are now making hand sanitizers. Clothing companies, textile companies have been making face masks. Then, you know, hotel owners have been providing their rooms for hospitals. Then Zoom, house party, WhatsApp, video calls, all these have become norm. Each and everyone, even, you know, the techies of the techies are using video calls or house party, and even the lower strata also, those who are not, you know, techie or not very online savvy, they are also now resorting to all these softwares. So we were talking to Bakshi ji, in fact, because unka jo exposure of India or US ka bahut zabardast exposure hai. So India has chosen lives over livelihood. India ne jaan ke liye opt kiya hai, aur US jahan ke liye opt kar rakha hai. And he explained us very properly, you know, before we started. So jo warm up session tha 6 baje se lekar 6 minute tak, so Bakshi ji ne bahut zabardast us time pe bataya ki he was the only president, he is the only president perhaps jitna mujhe dhyan hai जो बिजनेसमैन है ऑफिशियली, बाकी लोग तो सब हो गए अंदर से, पता नहीं, मे बी रशिया के होंगे या कहीं के भी होंगे, बट देन दे हैव ऑप्टेड फॉर जहान, बट इंडिया कुड नॉट, यू नो, कॉम्प्रोमाइज, एंड इंडिया के पास कोई ऑप्शन नहीं था कि दे कैन कॉम्प्रोमाइज विद जान. सो फॉर इंडिया इट वॉज पहले काया एंड फिर माया. सो वी विल टॉक अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक डिसरप्शंस ऑल्सो, यू नो, unprecedented economic catastrophe. In fact, the sheer scale of disruption is unprecedented. It's an extraordinary, as the, you know, RBI governor also used these words, extraordinary and unprecedented situations. So where the Indian government has also come up with the stimulus package of around 1,70,000 crores till date, which is very less. I think it will go up to more than 7 to 8 lakhs or 10 lakhs of crores. It will happen very soon. So every, you know, week or every say fortnight, we will come across some of the stimulus packages being announced. So as I told, you know, the disruption is much starker than the global financial crisis of 2008, which hit the Indian financial sector and real demand, but did not bring production to a halt. Now, you know, it's wealth and health. That time it was only wealth which was being disrupted. And besides, at that time, the Indian economy was much better placed as compared to the world economies and the other economies to handle the crisis. But now we are no different. We were at 4.75 or 4.5% of GDP, and even US was at 2.5% GDP. So while the lockdown have been necessary to limit the spread of coronavirus, it will not solve the problem as we assume, because, you know, we have been seeing lots of these cases also. Communalization is going on in the name of, you know, coronavirus. So let's see what happens in India, fingers crossed, and I hope it doesn't spread. So till date, you know, it's just 10,200-300, so let's see what happens. Abhi tak to kya Nifty ko cross kiya hai, ho sakta baad mein it will cross the bank Nifty and the Sensex also, and it can go.
I wanted to show you right here.
Yeah. So meanwhile, the vulnerable sections are bearing the brunt of the crisis. The daily wage workers are actually bearing the brunt, and consumption demand, the bedrock of Indian economy. In fact, Indian economy is a great consumption economy, and will also fall. The consumption will also fall due to the collapse in incomes, and private investors will be shaken and uncertain. And many small entrepreneurs, and India will face a big problem in terms of MSMEs and SMEs and the small traders and those micropreneurs, because India is basically, Indians are basically risk taking and enterprising also. And there are lots of self-employed businessmen. So they will have a very tough time. So let's see how it goes. Construction and services sector will get affected. A complete, so demand and supply. Then everywhere in the world, the government is recognizing, you know, there will be no time to worry about fiscal deficits and the like. Actually, I don't think, you know, government, Indian government is still, you know, thinking about the fiscal deficit, and they are yet, I think they're slow in, you know, announcing the stimulus package. The way the US economy and all the other economies are, they are like 10 to 15% of the GDP they have announced as, you know, the stimulus package quantum is so high. But in India, we are not seeing that. So let's see Indian government is working judiciously towards that. So let's see how things pan out. GDP projections, lots of these rating agencies and those big research houses are coming up with their GDP projections. India was actually at 4.75 or 8. So India was anyways not very strong. Things were not all that great if we see the ground reality. So let's see. So even though the country may not slip into recession, unlike the Euro and US zone or Asia Pacific, but and India will still have a very, very significant impact on the GDP. As we can see, you know, S&P has come up. Still, they are not that bearish on Indian economy. They are thinking that, you know, next year things will get revived. Again, Fitch has also given some signs of revival in their estimates. Then Moody's, they have actually given a very bad revised estimate, that is 2.5. And even I feel that, you know, the revised estimates will be closer to, you know, 2.5. And at times we have been reading that, you know, it can go to negative also. So let's see. CRISIL has given a revised forecast of 5.2. So it's a financial reset. Basically, everything is getting reset. So the world reserve currency generally gets reset when these kind of things happens. I'll just show you a slide, you know, where since 1450, how global reserve currencies have changed. It was Portugal, then Spain. Portugal ruled for 80 years. Then Spain came into the picture, 110 years. The Netherlands, France, Britain, 105 years till 1920. So, and now it's US who is ruling. So the dollar is basically the reserve currency. So now let's see what happens. It can be, you know, we are generally talking about three things, you know, God. So God, G is gold. We are seeing what gold is doing. It's already 46,000 plus. O is online businesses. Things will go online. Everything will, you know, everyone will go online. Otherwise, they will be out of line. And the last is D for dollar, D for dividend yield. So we are talking about dividend yield stocks. We're talking about dollars. So let's see what happens. We just know two things for certain. You know, freedom has always been and will still be at a premium. So we are talking about financial freedom, and we know that, you know, financial freedom will always be at a premium. It wasn't at a premium, and it is at a premium, and it will be at a premium. That's for sure. And being rich and liquid is the ultimate survival strategy. So you have to be liquid. After all these things, the liquidity's premium go very high. We never realized, you know, cash is king, liquidity is king. Last I realized was 2008 and 9. Now again, we have come to realize that, you know, at demonetization time also, India witnessed something like this. But now again, we are witnessing how liquidity has become important. So first survive, and then we will think of thriving. Black swan, you know, this is again a very, very fancy word in the world of financial markets. But again, you know, we are talking about, you know, this event is a black swan. Black swan is like, you know, the worst of any event can be called as a black swan. And Taleb is the person who coined this particular term. So those who are into stock markets, they know about black swan. But still, you know, he has clarified that, you know, this event is still predictable. Those which are extremely unpredictable are called black swan events. But this was predictable, the kind of effect it will have on the economies, or the kind of effect it will have in terms of the numbers of, you know, corona affected people. We are able to predict Six Sigma events. Yeah. Again, it's a Six Sigma event also. So corona has done one good thing. You know, all the things are very bad. One good thing is right companies are finally becoming rightly valuable. Right companies or right individuals, lots of things are actually apne ab asli value pe aage, dharatal pe aage. Ab cheeze unnecessary jo PE multiple pe chalti thi ya private equities wale koi bhi valuation pe kuch bhi dete the, shayad wo cheez ab kam hongi. Ab cheeze book value ki taraf aayengi, dharatal pe aane wali hai. That's what I feel. So, you know, we have seen, most of us must have seen the 2008 crisis and how people stopped talking about, you know, stock markets. And it was 2000. in year 2000 we saw how things got so bad that the Nifty went below 1000, below the base of 1000, and till 2002-03, till the Maruti IPO came and Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji came, things were extremely bad. So I think I'm not saying that it was because of Atal Bihari ji, Vajpayee or anyone. I will not try to politicize things. But 2003 onwards, we saw a very, very good economic development in India till 2008. But see what happened to Nifty. 2008, if we see, it corrected from 6300 levels. Then it spent time till October. So it was in the month of January 21st and 22nd. We saw circuit breakers on 21st and 22nd. One of the worst days we have seen in our lives. And this time we saw that on March 23rd, which was the worst of this particular mayhem. And then it spent time. Bolte na market time pass kar raha tha. And the time correction bolte. First, time correction hota hai. So the time correction was again till October. And we saw Nifty came to 4200. Then wapas se August mein. Phir October mein it came down to 2200. 6300 to 2200. So it was just one third. 2100, 2200. One third reh gaya tha. So we have to be very careful, That's why I just brought this slide, It's always good to know the history. Kai baar aisa ho jata, lots of times we are receiving calls. Mere wo Twitter pe aate hai, mere jo followers hai, ya hum log ke jo clients hai, sab log itne phone se bombarding ho rahi hai ki hume maal kharidna hai. And even I know lots of time members also, bahut sare members, bahut sare attendees, usme se kam, I think one third log to hamare client hai, ya humse associated hai, one way or the other. So sab ka hum dekhte hai ki sab ko paisa lagana hai, but we cannot be that sure that, it is the best time, or we have to find out better ways how to utilize, how to put this money into the markets. And we will talk about that. So again, this is one punchline which I have got. NPS are the only constant in this country. In the past also we have seen. So previously it was with the PSU banks. Now it is getting transferred to private sector banks also. Is Bargaj, unpe bhi padhne wali, NBFCs and private sector banks. So all this financial sector is the worst affected, be it microfinance companies, be it auto finance companies, or even the gold finance companies are also not doing all that great, though the gold is at lifetime highs in Indian context. Impact on various sectors and companies. So companies and sectors that can have lesser cut in earnings for FY21, and they are consumer staples to the healthcare sector and telecom. So we have been recommending these sectors. And I think these sectors like, FMCG or say pharma or healthcare, like say even medical devices companies or these say diagnostic center businesses. So diagnostic businesses and telecom. Telecom to aisi cheez hai ki data khane se zyada kha rahe hain log baag. Data is the most consumed item in the world. Aur abhi at this, sorry?
Bij.
And at this moment, if we see since the lockdown has started, so it is the data which has been consumed the most. Then, so these are the sectors from where we started recommending stocks. And humne inme strategies banai hai rather than, going haywire. Jo bhi stock 50% correct ho gaya, unme ghus jaye. Aisa samay bhi abhi aaya nahi hai. So companies and sectors that can demonstrate faster recovery in case of a economic rebound. So that will be consumer goods, TV, fridge, jo basically discretionary consumption mein jo consumer goods hote hain, iron kharidna, cooker kharidna, ye jo choti choti consumer items jo ghar mein chahiye, to shayad they will recover after the economy starts recovering. Then crude oil prices. I have read an article where crude oil is already at $20 ke aaspaas, it is trying to trade, and there is so much of politics going on in that, and so much of volatility, extreme volatility. If you see the prices of this month and the next month, the badla, the spread or the contango, so if we have to roll over, it is 500 rupees. The difference is 500 rupees. So in 2 to 3 months of rollover, the whole price of the underlying gets wiped off. And there are various countries which are producing crude oil. So, say Texas in US, so Middle East, and then we see Canada also. In Canada, the crude is trading at $4 because it's actually literally trading like aloo pyaaz. Jaise aloo fek dete na cold storage mein jagah nahi hai, fek do koi bhi bhav pe le jao. Waise crude oil ki halat ek time pe abhi recently ho gayi thi. Manufacture karna hi hai unko, crude oil ko nikalna hi hai, and they have to basically store it also. And storage ki crisis ho rahi hai, storage ki jagah nahi hai. So crude oil is going through a very bad phase. Then shell gas ka wahan pe US mein abhi pichle saalon mein kafi capacities develop hue hain. So but crude oil agar itna niche hota hai, to paints and chemical industry, oil marketing companies and airline companies, they will get benefited. But airline companies are actually not getting benefited because of the airlines are being closed down. So let's see when they will get open. May 3rd is the next date. Then specialty chemicals, we talked about China. Bakshiji was talking about China, ki kaise manufacturing base shift ho sakta India tak. And already specialty chemicals mein China mein jab problem aa rahi thi recently, specialty chemicals ki kuch companies, they were doing extremely well. Companies like Atul Limited, Navin Fluorine, there are lots of companies, SRF, they are doing very well in specialty chemicals. And India will certainly do well on this front. And I think this is a great opportunity for India to beat China, because China ke liye things will be very different post. It will be as neglected as I think Iran or these countries or North Korea. So let's see what happens. But then that's China. The size, the sheer size of the Chinese market is such that, you know, we cannot avoid China. But then kafi cheeze hone wali hai. Then labor market is already, you know, we are seeing an unrest there. It's already dislocated. So वहां पे बहुत प्रॉब्लम आने वाली है. सो इट्स वेरी नेगेटिव फॉर द रियल एस्टेट एंड द इंडस्ट्रियल्स, दोज कंपनीज और द एसएमईज एंड द स्मॉलर इंटरमीडिएट मैन्युफैक्चरर्स, दे विल हैव अ वेरी टफ टाइम. देन द वर्स्ट अफेक्टेड इज अगेन आई टॉक्ड अबाउट फाइनेंशियल्स, द प्राइवेट सेक्टर बैंक्स, क्योंकि पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स तो ऑलरेडी अफेक्टेड है, उनके यहाँ तो कुछ अब बचा ही नहीं है. 25% की एवरेज एनपीए चल रही है पीएसयूज में, मतलब तीन चार बैंक्स के अलावा सब लोग 20-25 इज अ नॉर्म देयर, इट्स अ नॉर्मल थिंग. And NBFCs also, selected NBFCs, maybe gold NBFCs पे इतना impact नहीं पड़े, and HFCs पे नहीं पड़ेगा, companies like say HDFC and all, because their client base is a very quality client base. So let's see. But MFIs and all these companies will be very badly affected. You know, those companies who are dealing with rural markets, they might get affected. It will take time. So Shriram Transport Finance and all these companies, so they will take time to recover. Yeah. So interesting insights. People will not spend on luxury, so they will come down drastically. Then long term or capital expenditure such as construction, technology will be almost cut to nil. So that is a reality. I think people will certainly curtail on those expenses. So lifestyle expenditure such as salary, rent, infrastructure, entertainment will also get minimized. Maybe for next 6 months, working capital will be under tremendous pressure. Businesses will go out of business, especially those who are riding on borrowed working capital. So we are actually focusing only on debt-free companies or near zero debt companies. It's very important, you know, to look for companies, to look for players who are zero debt. And those companies have actually not corrected. If you see the pharma companies or FMCGs, they are actually, you know, cash cows, and they are generating good cash flows out of literally negative working capital. HUL is working on negative working capital. Negative working capital is again a very different term, but then, you know, that is how they work on. Raw materials are being procured on credit and the sales are being made on cash. So that is how they are working on negative working capital. Then new innovative business models will evolve. Say maybe, you know, webinar, maybe people will curtail on the marketing team, maybe the owner, maybe previously our marketing team used to go to the clients, but now with, you know, webinars, we can do a webinar, we can talk to our clients through webinars. So people will try to go online, people will talk about augmented reality, people will talk about virtual reality, lots of things will happen. AI and all these online machine learning, lots of things will happen. EdTech businesses will do well. People's consumption of essential will continue. Rise in investment on ideas and technology will improve efficiency. Short-term trading businesses with healthy cash flow practices will thrive. Rise in investment on spiritual and self-learning practices. People will actually have started already thinking on them. And value for money. Value for money. People will really talk about value for money. The unnecessary conspicuous consumption or luxurious consumption will take a beating for some months at least. Ek saal baki to logon ki yaadas bahut kamzor hoti hai. Log bhul jate hain jaldi jaldi. Demon bhi aaya tha, chala gaya. Bahut sari cheeze aayi hai, chali gayi hai. So it takes generally 1.5 saal se 2 saal things get, you know, settled down. So this is again a repeat. We are. So what should we do as an entrepreneur? We should really take care of our employees, and we should use the slowdown to improve upon processes. And actually, we are doing it in our company. We are really trying to. We were actually trying to, you know, save on some cost. Now we are actually getting very aggressive. We are trying to invest on technologies and systems, and we are getting very frugal with working operating expenses. Night is darkest before dawn, and luck favors the brave. And certainly, we have to be brave enough. And I know, I'm very sure, Thai SEX platform, and it's a beautiful platform with great entrepreneurs. So, मुझे लगता है कि 175-80 entrepreneurs are there, and all are very very brave, and fortune really favors the brave. Luck to baad mein aata hai, and everyone are actually working towards it. The way everyone is so serious about attending webinars also. So these are some opportunities where we should, you know, the major opportunities. The whole world is desisting China post COVID-19. Sooner or later, China will also get isolated, just like Iran and North Korea. And there will be lots of class action suits filed in the US against China. And this would be India's big opportunity to shine in the world, at the world stage. So let's see how it happens. And our economy will certainly stabilize faster than others, because we are a domestic consumption economy. So let's see. So we should emerge as a big manufacturing hub also in the coming days, because our labor costs are very low. And again, now, you know, after this unrest, I think the cost will further go down. And as maine jo bola ki dharatal pe sab kuch jana padega, and it will happen. And corporate tax cut, jo Nirmala Sitaraman ki big candle, big rally bolte hum log, jo September 20th it happened. So that was one day which was really changing the Indian economy, and it changed the Indian markets also. 10,675 se the market went to 12,300-12,400, but again it came down because of corona. Otherwise the markets were doing very well before the budget. And the low oil prices, oil this time India is also working on, you know, trying to create a strategic oil reserve. And the way US has a strategic oil reserve, India is also coming up with such ideas. And I think they will buy lots of puts or calls also. They will try to, you know, manage crude oil through hedging in options also. I think that's what things are being, you know, read. That's what I've been reading. So let's see what happens. But this time, this is a great opportunity for the country also, and for every one of us. जिन्होंने पास्ट में कोई प्लानिंग की वजह से गलतियां की है, नाउ वी हैव अ चांस टू करेक्ट आवर सेल्व इंडिविजुअली एंड एज अ कंट्री ऑल्सो. एंड कंट्री के लिए जो क्रूड ऑयल फ्रंट पे इंडिया में प्रॉब्लम्स आ रही थी, दैट विल सर्टेनली गेट रिजॉल्व. एंड आई एम वेरी वेरी बुलिश ऑन दिस फ्रंट, यू नो दैट इंडिया विल सर्टेनली कम अप विद ग्रेट सोल्यूशंस ऑन एटलीस्ट क्रूड ऑयल फ्रंट. So we at TradeShift call ourselves as, you know, financial freedom fighters. This is what the topic is all about. And this is a financial freedom questionnaire also. And we will send you the questionnaire. This is just to show that, you know, this is how the questionnaire looks like. We have an online questionnaire also. And after the webinar, I would love you all to, you know, fill up this particular form online. And it's available on, I think, Google Drive only. So you can fill it up, Google Forms. And then, you know, we will send you a proper plan how to manage the crisis and how you can, you know, work on your financial planning post corona. So these are some questions, and we are talking about, you know, how well you are insured, how well you are invested in mutual funds, if equity, then how much in cash, how much in FNO, whether you trade or not, commodities, currencies. There are lots of exporters also, and we have done a seminar on currency futures also in the past, where, you know, we talked about hedging. That was long back in 2010-11, I think, in Thai. Twice or thrice we have done this, particularly on SME listing also and currencies also. Then this is the financial freedom questionnaire. Then financial freedom through financial planning and financial replanning. Financial planning to sab toss ho gaya. It has gone for a toss. Now it is financial replanning we will have to work on. So this is a very big, you know, punchline. You know, failing to plan is planning to fail. If you are not planning, if you are failing to plan, then you are actually planning for your own failure. So now, jaisa maine bola ki reset button dab gaya hai. Jo galtiya past mein ki hai, now we have a great chance to rework, because we all are back in our career, in our work. So let's see how things pan out. But abhi aisa lagta hai, maybe I might be sounding too pessimistic also at times when it is coming to individuals, but I'm very optimistic when it is coming to the economy. So as a whole, I'm a very optimistic person, but when it comes to managing, micromanaging, so individuals, we have to be pessimistic and we have to check the reality. After that reality check, we have to replan things. So this is comfort versus growth zone. We all are in the fear zone, or learning to itni ho rahi hai nowadays, all these you know, the videos, social media, WhatsApp, then Twitter also, then Zoom, then webinars. So people are actually working on the, you know, learning thing, and people are actually trying to acquire new skills also. But growth zone, abhi time hai, but again, we have to find a purpose. Dreams to ab sare ab kharab ho gaye, ek bure sapne se hum niklenge. New goals ab set karne padenge, that is more important. Then we have to aggressively set those goals and aggressively try to conquer our objectives. So financial planning is nothing but an ongoing process to help you make sensible decisions about money that can help you achieve your goals in life. Yahan pe time hai financial planning ke bare mein bolna, shayad thoda sa wo ho jayega. Already people are very very smart and people are really very very financially planned. Ho sakta hai ki main gyan de raha hu, but I may not be that financially planned, as I can see lots of members, because they actually get in touch with us, say professionally also and otherwise also, being friends also. So pata chalta ki log baag bahut serious hai regarding financial planning. But ab jo serious hona hua financial replanning ke liye, it is very important to replan things. So ye buying a house, higher education, these were the basic goals. Ab new goals are basically about survival, how to manage businesses, how to manage the team, how to motivate the team, kaise aage business ko online karna hai, technology pe cost. So I think there are lots of plans. Maybe ye mere goals hai, dusron ke dusre honge. Kisi ke debts zyada honge to unko debts ko kam karna padega. Kisi ko debts liye hue hai, unko debts ko repay karna padega. Log mangne wale zyada rahenge. So things will change, planning and replanning will happen. So re-establish your goals, gather data, kya kya kar sakte hain. Then evaluate your current position, reality check karni padegi, then develop a new plan, then implement that plan very very aggressively, and then monitor, kyunki har cheez ko bahut aggressively plan ko implement karna zaruri, otherwise we'll have a very tough time just sitting idle and working on nothing. Actually these are the best days, these lockdown days, where we can really introspect, where we can really plan, where we can really clean up ourselves, and we can plan for our future businesses and future investments. So generally, you know, current asset allocation is gold, FDs and debts, NSEs, mutual funds, real estate. But abhi jo sabse important jo is pure episode ke baad laga, those who were sitting on FDs, they were not losers. Those who were sitting on gold, because gold generally do not form the 100% portion of the general portfolios. Maybe in India kacche mein gold lete hain, jewelry ke form mein we have gold, sufficient gold, but generally gold 10-15% rehta hai. Then debts, FDs log baag age ke hisab se banate hain. Mutual funds mein log kafi invested, and I can really see lots of people who are doing SIP, and jitne bhi agar 45-50 attendees hai, so I think most of them must be having SIPs also. Then direct equity exposure also people will be having, but then risk management and risk samajh ke risk reward sab mein different hai, so we have to be very cautious about this. Risk profiling, risk averse, conservative, moderate, aggressive. So jaisa jaisa hota hai, aggressive hai to wo equities mein jata hai, conservative hai to wo FDs mein jayega. इमरजेंसी फंड एनालिसिस जो अभी जो टाइम चल रहा है. सो दिस इज वन थिंग पीपल हैव रियलाइज्ड, यू नो दैट व्हाट इज इमरजेंसी फंड एंड फॉर फ्यूचर ऑल्सो, बिकॉज यू नेवर नो हाउ लॉन्ग द वैक्सीन विल टेक टाइम टू कम एंड हाउ लॉन्ग वी विल बी फेसिंग दिस सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग, हाउ लॉन्ग वी विल नॉट बी ट्रेवलिंग, हाउ लॉन्ग लॉट्स ऑफ बिजनेसेस विल नॉट गेट ओपन. सो थिंग्स विल बी नॉट दैट इजी फॉर एटलीस्ट नेक्स्ट 6 to 9 months. एंड आई डोंट नो, आई वॉज जस्ट डिस्कसिंग विद you know someone this morning that you know the fastest vaccine which could be you know researched and then came to the market, that was the Ebola vaccine, and it took 6 years. So this is the fastest, 6 years. So let's forget that you know the vaccine for corona will come that fast. Though things are working, lots of big companies, and when US gets after a thing and the way they are not actually closing down their economy, so they have, and Trump has actually instructed all the pharma companies and all the big companies like Pfizer, Abbott or Sanofi, they are working very, very aggressively, and they are like big research budget companies. They are not those normal. If I can remember, they have more than 1,000 PhDs working in, you know, only Pfizer. So they have got a huge research base. So let's see. Cash, short-term deposits. So those people who are actually having emergency fund, I am receiving lots of calls. You know, we are receiving calls where, you know, people actually try to, you know, invest these emergency funds also, whatever funds they are left with. But we have been suggesting, you know, at least you should not invest your emergency funds, because you never know whenever you will require that fund in your business, because your business might not work also, your business might not generate profits also. So you might have to burn some cash in your business. So just put that money in FD rather than, you know, trying to take an opportunity of the corrected markets. Ki itna toota hua market hai, main ek bar dal deta hu paisa, fir jab chahiyega main nikal deta hu. That day you might not see markets at highs, they might be at much lower than the levels where you have invested. So us time pe fir maal becha nahi jayega, again you will land up yourself in a bigger crisis. So isliye bahut important hai ki is fund ko aap normal FDs mein rakhe, aur FDs bhi aap zyada idhar udhar ke banks ko explore nahi kare, with safer banks only. I will not name them, but certainly I can name about SBI, and private sector mein bhi you can guess the names. So we have to be very, very particular about that. Life insurance. जब डीमोन हुआ था, I recommended a life insurance stock that was ICICI Pru at 280 levels, and it went up to 450. Reason being, you know, when these bad times come, people only think about risk, people only think about protection, people only think about saving, you know, about their family from those adversities. So I think life insurance, and if any one of us, I think everyone should be having a term plan here, because I really see very financially planned people here, and they are very smart also that way. But generally, dusre jagah jab jaate hain, where we do seminars, say in a normal audience also, or entrepreneurs also, and even bigger businessmen, maybe in say Northeast or Calcutta, har jagah term plan ka itna zyada nahi hai. So I'm very bullish that, you know, these insurance companies will do very well. Financialization theme will really work in India. And term insurance will be bought by everyone, and one should really buy term insurance. Baki sab bekar hai. Maine Mr. Bakshi ko, maine aur Nishant ne long back we sold him a ULIP also, and of 10 lakhs premium, sir. So if you remember that day, so that was a very big premium at that point of time. And now if we see, we generally sell term plan, and on the other hand we sell mutual funds. And protection planning in terms of non-life insurance, this is again very important to check that, you know, we have our medical insurance in place, property insurance, motor to sab lete hai, key man insurance, professional liability insurance. I just read an article today that, you know, Chennai Super Kings was the only IPL league team which was insured. That particular, they insured their business, and rest none of the teams were insured. So see the, you know, vision of the owner of that company, India Cements wale log jo owner hai. So they have now separated the company from India Cements also, and it's a separate company. And So these are like risk return trade-offs, direct equity, mutual funds, as per, you know, the risk goes higher, then direct equity is the highest risk. Then invest money. This is a typical, you know, financial planning like slide where, you know, you invest as much as possible. Invest at highest rate possible. Highest rate ka matlab ye nahi ki 4% pe paisa laga de. It is basically at best rate possible, best opportunity. Invest as long as possible. Gambling, and you know, you have to invest, you have to do proper diversification. Then financial goals we talked about. Hope for the best, expect the worst. Nothing can be as worse as, you know, what we are seeing. The only wrong thing is to do nothing about protecting your financial future. So we really have to protect ourselves in terms of, you know, buying these insurances and doing these financial planning in terms of investments also. But aaj ki date mein investments ka jyada relevance nahi aata hai. Then these are the investments, guaranteed return investments, non-guaranteed. Now I will suggest that, you know, people should be sticking to the guaranteed return investments where you can use your, you know, money for burning cash in your businesses like FDs and these things, equity and those things, those who are sitting on idle cash, unwanted money. And so these are some seasons and preferences of, you know, investment. Spring season, summer season, autumn season, we have seasons in investment also. So now we are in the winter part where there will be depression, where there will be deflationary trend. We will see a recession like in 1929-30. It may not be as bad as that. Let's see. But then people will only talk about, you know, gold, cash and commodities in late cycle. Maybe commodities like, you know, steel or base metals. People might, you know, invest on those if they have corrected. Then worst investments will be real estate or stocks, bonds. Then characteristics of these particular times are deflation, debt collapse, trade conflicts, social upheaval, economic war. So let's see if we see all these things or not. Return generated. This is a very interesting slide. We only talk about Warren Buffett. So see, Warren Buffett generated only 18% over these years. There are people who invest, who generated 120 also. Richard Dennis, one of the biggest stock market players, he generated 120%, but that was only for 19 years. The bracket is 19. And Warren Buffett has been, he is the richest investor in the world. He has been generating 18% CAGR, and he was sitting on cash before. The reason for getting this slide is he was actually waiting for this kind of event to happen, and he was sitting almost on cash, and he was not getting opportunities to invest in businesses or anywhere. And now he is ready with his money to invest. But still, you know, his return was 18 years, but that was for 54 years consecutively he has been generating. Direct participation in equity markets. This is what, you know, we talk about. This is what I deal with, equity markets. So, you know, challenges involved in investing directly in capital markets is time, expertise, lack of information, portfolio, volatility. Volatility is one thing which was so difficult to, you know, handle in the last month. It went up to 85, 86, the VIX in India. It was as low as 10 to 12. Then when Modiji's election was there, that was 2014, that time it was 32, 33. And that time we thought that, you know, it was very, very high. And CBO VIX, people track CBO VIX more, that is US's volatility index, that went up to say 85, 87, 89. So Indian VIX also went up to that. So now it is at 50. So this is one thing which is very, very difficult to actually handle. Volatility is one thing which is very difficult. That's where, you know, greed and fear. Itna hi volatility dekh ke koi bhi aadmi dar jata, acche se acha aadmi bhi, bade se bada conviction wala investor bhi aise volatility dekh ke darta hai. And aise mahol mein har aadmi galat jagah pe katta hai, har aadmi ke paise lage hai. There is not even a single person who made money in this fall. Now people might be making money, but you never know for how long. These are the animals in the stock market jungle. Everyone is a bull. There are bears, there are ostrich, wolf. People must have seen the movie also, The Wolf of the Wall Street. They are basically investors who use resources and use unscrupulous methods and manipulate the system to make returns. So this is one thing people really get trapped into. So these wolves are there in the market. They operate the markets. They use the information. They use the resources. So we should be very, very careful. And this is where, you know, this is one animal in the jungle, stock market jungle, which we advise to be careful of. So this is one funny slide. You know, people go to the doctor. This is one, you know, market is continuously going up. Everyone is happy. Market is continuously going down. We all are worried. Then market is tremendously volatile. We all are confused. It's not confused. People are totally in despair. People are so afraid in these days. So what should we do in these three different situations? So this is what, you know, this is called rebalancing. Rebalancing between greed and fear. Speculation may be injurious to your wealth. So this is what we generally preach, that, you know, don't unnecessarily trade in the markets. Only invest. People are generally investors here in this forum. But generally, so is not the case. Lots of people really do trade and lose money. In investing, we have to remember that, you know, Rome was built, not built in a day. In trading, Hiroshima and Nagasaki was destroyed in a day. Patient, doctor ke paas jata ki, I'm not able to make money. So doctor bolta hai, you are suffering from a market timing syndrome. Khali market ko time karna, lowest pe lena, highest pe bechna. So get a sip to cure it. दवाई की सिप नहीं, SIP की दवाई लेनी है टू क्योर दिस पर्टिकुलर सिंड्रोम. सो दीज आर समथिंग, यू नो, वी जनरली डू. दीज आर सम स्मॉल प्रोडक्ट्स, प्राइमरी वे ऑफ, यू नो, पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द मार्केट्स, वेर यू कैन, यू नो, रियली ट्राई टू मेक मनी आउट ऑफ स्टॉक मार्केट्स. देन वी जनरली डू अ सर्वे ऑल्सो. सो नाउ आई एम नॉट एबल टू इंटरेक्ट विद एवरी वन, बट जनरली हम लोग ये स्लाइड दिखाते और पूछते हैं जब सेमिनार में रहते हैं कि अगर ये तीनों एक्टर्स लिस्टेड होते तो विच वन वॉज द एक्टर विच यू वुड हैव इन्वेस्टेड इन. सो आई थिंक अभी भी सारों के आंसर आमिर खान ही होगा. आई एम वेरी श्योर अबाउट इट. सो सलमान खान नंबर टू होगा, देन शाहरुख खान. मे बी लॉट्स ऑफ फैंस माइट बी देयर फॉर शाहरुख खान ऑल्सो. बट फंडामेंटल एंड टेक्निकल एंड कॉर्पोरेट गवर्नेंस एनालिसिस, फंडामेंटल एनालिसिस सीख सकते हैं, टेक्निकल एनालिसिस भी सीख सकते हैं. बट कॉर्पोरेट गवर्नेंस एनालिसिस इज वन थिंग which is very, very difficult. And yahan pe time hai, what I see is we have got a very, very good knack over, you know, doing corporate governance analysis, because we deal with startups, we look at the promoters, we interview them, we check their profile. So ye corporate governance analysis mein, generally listed companies mein, people forget to do these kind of corporate governance analysis. So these are some indicators. We can share the presentation. Then ratios and parameters, what we see to select the stocks. Then margins, net profit margins, and all these things. Return on capital employed is very important again. Then we implement the technical indicators also. We check the trends, RSI. These are some technical terms. Moving averages. We look at even, you know, 1,000-day moving averages, 200-day moving averages. Very important for fundamental investors. 200 din ki trading average ke niche jata to market kharab ho jata hai. Price scans we do, corporate governance, board composition, and all these things, ethics, then ESG, then important points to consider while analyzing a company. So last 10-year financials, then shareholding patterns, management ka discussion, then algo trading. Yeah, this is one point which I really want to discuss. This is where the money lies. The world over, 80% of the trading is done on algo. Even the investments are done on algo. And so this is where, you know, in the last month when we were working on algos, you won't believe, markets were not doing well, but still, you know, the algos were not trading. So lots of times by not trading also you are trading, because the VIX was above 50. So even in this particular bad month also in March, it was at 0.86% returns. In April, it was 4.82% return till date, till last Thursday. And these were the picks which we recommended recently. Never make a no picks. Generally on TV also we do this. So we just talked about CDSL, BSE. These are online businesses. TCS is again at a great valuation. FDC, jo electrol banati hai company, pharma company. Pfizer is a pharma company. Six of them are pharma companies. M6 is an online business. ITC, great valuations. Then PGHL is Procter & Gamble, jo Merck Pharma thi. Polymedical, again a Jaipur based and a Delhi based company, jahan pe Merck ke naam se Polymedical yellow medical devices banate hain. So all is well that ends well. I think maine 3 minute reh gaye hain. So we are on the 22nd day of the 40 day countdown to lockdown. Happy replanning, happy investing, happy plans. Swasth rahe, vyast rahe, and mast rahe. Thank you so much for the patient hearing. Open for questions. ये प्रेजेंटेशन बंद कर देगा कैसे बोलते हैं बोलना नहीं
संदीप आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन वेयर डू यू सी द यूएस डॉलर गोइंग फ्रॉम हियर बिकॉज़ अ लॉट डिपेंड्स ऑन दैट आल्सो वी ऑलरेडी ऑल द एक्सपोर्टर्स हैव अ लेवरेज ऑफ अबाउट 6-7% ऑलरेडी देयर बिकॉज़ द डॉलर हैज स्ट्रेंथेंड बट वेयर डज इट लुक लाइक गोइंग फ्रॉम नाउ
Was this is Shekhar, right?
Yeah,
Shekhar. Yeah, can you repeat the question? I'm so sorry.
My question is, where do you see the dollar going, and what do you think is going to be the impact of the dollar is on an upward move right now. It has already created a leverage of about 7-8% for all the exporters. Yeah. What do you think happens further up?
I think dollar will go up because I already talked about this reserve currency also, and we feel that technically the dollar is very, very strong, and fundamentally also because the economies will go down, India might revive, but then at this point of time I think people will resort to stronger currencies, and that will be dollar. And US economy is not closed, Indian economy is down with lockdown, so let's see what happens. I think the RBI is intervening in between, and due to RBI intervention the fall is not as fast as it could have been, and I think it can go up to 79 levels. That's what our technical parameters say, 20 day moving average, 50 moving average, sab ke upar hai, and it's in a blue sky zone. So blue sky zone mein rehta to limit ka pata nahi, but technically 79 should be a level where it should reach.
So Sandeep, one question for you or one comment. Since we are all Thai people, we should also consider at least some small portion of our reserves or whatever we want to call it for some very unusual startups that might do very well. So that's something that we should all think about.
Yes, sir. Yeah, certainly.
Sandeep, can you elaborate a little more on algo? You said the last slide.
Yeah, algo is basically algorithmic trading. It's automated trading. When we talk about automated trading, it's basically we develop a software, we develop our strategy, we code that, and that strategy works on its own, in the sense that and we then re-evolve it and it trades on its own. Targets achieve hote to ye nikal jata hai, wapas se trail karta hai target ko, stop loss pe nikalta hai. Those which we cannot do, jaise ek signal hota hai traffic signal pe, agar wo automated signal rehta to jam nahi lagti hai, but when there is a police man controlling the signal, might be wahan jam dikhne lag jati hai. So this is how algo works. And algo aisi cheez hai, agar aap dekho Gary Kasparov ko aap aise chess mein hara nahi sakte ho, magar uski sari strategies ko agar aap algo mein dal dete ho and multiple permutation combinations ke sath aap karte ho, to ho sakta hai you can fight with it. So this is how you can fight with the market, and 80% of the volumes algo se aate, aur wahan pe जो ग्रीड एंड फियर का जो टेंशन रहता है ह्यूमन इंटरवेंशन का, वो खत्म हो जाता है. ये रूथलेसली अपने सौदों को काटता है, रूथलेसली अपने सौदों से एग्जिट कर जाता है, टारगेट अचीव होता है, निकलता है. जैसे आज का दिन ही था, आज का दिन एक्सट्रीमली वॉलेटाइल था, तो एक बार इट वॉज मेकिंग मनी, मे बी एट वन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम जीरो पे आया तो निकल गया. सो इट एक्ट्स वेरी फास्ट, एंड इसीलिए जो इतनी वॉलेटिलिटी होती है ह्यूमनली, इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फाइट अगेंस्ट दैट वॉलेटिलिटी. So that's why we recommend, and it is doing very well. And without actually resorting to algos, it's very, very difficult to make money in these markets. For investing, it's fine, but when it comes to trading, you have to be with algos. There are a couple of members who have actually started this trading with us on algo. Yeah.
Okay.
I think I've made my point clear.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sandeep, similar. Hi, this is Prateek here. Similar question related to algo. So, as a retail investor, I mean, are we allowed to go through algo trade, or it's through like specific securities like we need to get associated with?
You have to come go through a member only, and the member gets enabled itself for an algo trading. This thing, we have to take a license, and we are basically algo enabled members only. Then we have our own strategies. Even in lots of strategies are working, 6-7 strategies are working with us. And particularly we are working on Nifty and Bank Nifty weekly options, because there the money is lying and the premiums are very high. So retail investors can certainly come up with it, but then there is a barrier of at least investments. Minimum investment is 25 lakhs.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have one more query, Sandeep. See, gone are those days when, you know, when during our previous generations, people used to invest in Reliance and they just left it for 10, 20 years and money has doubled or compounded by tenfold time. But since 2008 onwards, you know, we have seen the large cap stocks even falling down by 50%, 80%. So what should be the ideal strategy rather than investing for long term, like 10 years or 20 years? Don't you think we should now work on percentage profits, like 15%, 20%, we should move out irrespective of how big brand, like it is HDFC Limited or it is a Reliance Industries?
No, it depends. You know, you cannot exit a stock like that. There has to be an exit strategy. And this is one question which I ask to all these big investors and celebrity investors whenever I go to any seminar. Be it Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, be it Vijay Kedia, jinse bhi mila main, Mark Mobius se bhi mila, to unko bhi maine yahi question pucha hai ki ye exit strategy kya hoti hai. So it is very important, you know, what is your strategy of, you know, investing in that stock. And Infosys, TCS, HDFC, they have been continuously, consistently giving 20% CAGR of growth. So there is no point in exiting that stock. But yes, it is very important post-corona that percentages thing will really work. And then, you know, again, zero debt company, beautiful companies like, say, HUL was outperforming. It is again at highs, lifetime highs. Nestle is at lifetime highs. So defensive stocks, it has to be a strategy. There are around 25 parameters we look at. And even if these things have happened, they have actually bounced back very fast. So there is no single answer to this question, actually.
Okay.
It has to be very, very stock specific. Yeah.
There are a few questions on the chat. Sandeep, if you would like to take it up.
Yeah, chat. Yeah, actually, I'm not able to open the screen, just a sec. Chat pe questions.
I'll read it out for you in the meantime.
Yeah, read out.
How to deal with valuation heuristics as a contingency while investing in equity markets?
How to deal with valuation
heuristics?
Okay. Valuation is very important. It's a very good question, in fact, you know. It's a great question, and lots of times, you know, even in these markets, if you see HUL, that is trading at a P multiple of 75 plus. And I was talking to a very, very senior professor who is an author of a book called Corporate Finance, which is being read by, you know, the CFA students. Even he was very surprised to see the valuations and weird the valuations of, you know, HUL at 75, 79, 80, and there is a company called, you know, Naukri.com, that is Info Edge Solutions, that is trading at 100 plus P multiple even in these bad times. So koi criteria nahi hote, it's your basically personal perception, you know, where you have to work. But then it is also very important sector ka, sector wise alag alag valuations rehti hai. FMCG ko jyada valuations diya ja raha hai. Then IT, pharma was not doing well, but now again, you know, pharma is at a P multiples of say 15 to 20, average P multiple of the industry. Then IT, maybe 20, 25 is generally the valuation multiple of say TCS, but Wipro, same similar type of company, is trading at 10 P multiple. So it depends on lots of things, and जब अगर पी इन्वेस्टर्स आते हैं प्राइवेट इक्विटी वाले, वी हैव सीन लॉट्स ऑफ एग्जांपल्स, यू नो दे देयर मेन क्राइटेरिया इज टू गेट लिस्टेड ऑन द स्टॉक मार्केट्स टू गिव देम अ एग्जिट, एंड दिस इज द स्ट्रेटजी ऑफ ऑल दीज पी इन्वेस्टर्स और द वेंचर कैपिटलिस्ट. दे जनरली गेट द कंपनीज लिस्टेड इन विच दे आर इन्वेस्टेड, एंड वेन दे गेट listed, they take an exit, and it has happened in the past also. There was a company called Geodesic, and you know they got listed and it was as high as 150 rupees, and within a year's time it came down to 2 rupees, and now it is not trading. So there are n number of things. Again, there is no single answer. You can talk and talk on this particular front, and there are books on it, and it's a big debate. But yes, it's a very good question. As per me, I really look at, you know, P multiples of say 12 to 20, then the growth rate also 20% CAGR, then 20% of ROC, 20% of ROE, 15% of ROE maybe, and net profit growth. So all these are some 15 to 20 criteria which we see, and then we get into it. But I won't buy a stock of, you know, 7900 P multiple. Actually, we are selling the calls and options of those stocks as on date.
So the next question is about G of your God strategy.
G, okay. God.
So the question is from Sanjay Goyal. He says that with so much of QE going on in USA, where do you see gold in next 12 months?
Interesting. Gold revalue karega. Jitna Q hota utna gold ke liye acha, because the whole money chases gold only. Risky assets ke taraf jayenge nahi. So jitna print hota wo gold ke liye ek tarike se wo ज्यादा अट्रैक्ट करता हो गोल्ड, एंड आई थिंक गोल्ड विल गो अप ओनली फ्रॉम हियर. मे बी इट इज 48,000 to 49,000 विच वी सी, एंड रूपी विल ऑल्सो गेट डीवैल्यूड, सो अगेन वो मल्टीपल भी बढ़ जाएगा, एंड देन यू नो व्हेन सो मच ऑफ मनी इज बीइंग प्रिंटेड, गोल्ड रीएडजस्ट इट्स वैल्यू एक्चुअली. सो जनरली 4-5% की रीएडजस्टमेंट भी होनी है, तो गोल्ड विल गेट रीएडजस्टेड टू द प्रिंटेड अमाउंट ऑफ क्वांटम ऑफ प्रिंटेड मनी. इट्स अ वेरी macro and a broad based assumption, but then this is how it has been working. So I think gold will go up again. So downside to kam lagti hai.
Right. And the last question I can see on the window is, can we access cheap loans from US and Europe in India?
Cheap loans. Oh, external commercial borrowings. So I think bahut barriers hai. It's not that easy to borrow from, matlab, from US and all. Maybe उनके कोई NRI friend है, जुगाड़ कर सकते हैं कि किसी NRI को बोल दिया कि आप लोन ले लीजिए और हमें यहाँ पे दे दीजिए. Carry trade is anyways going on. So those big companies does this and those big funds does this. And again, वो भी अब carry trade again will happen. In 2008, post 2008 also it happened. So again, we will see carry trades. But for an individual borrowing from US, it will not that be easy. For a corporate, yes. But then again, you have to have those credentials also. It's not that easy. I hope the presentation was sensible and useful also.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, thank you. Khali Arun ne bola, baki log ne nahi bole.
Thanks Sandeep for wonderful presentation.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Sandeep.
Thank you, Nishant. Thanks a lot. Bye, Sandeep. Thanks. Bye, guys.
Take care.
Bye, Arun. Take care.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.